Hi, my name's Kathy.
Uh-huh.
How you doing today?
Fine.
I like your pretty dress.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I noticed you were at the sing-along down there a few minutes ago.
Uh-huh.
What are some of your favorite songs?
Well, let me think. I can't think of them right now. You know how you try to think of something.
I have that problem, too. Sometimes I'll try to think of a song name, and then I just can't come up with it.
I do the same thing.
Have you lived in Evansville a long time?
No. No. Very short time. Mm-hmm. I've lived in Evansville quite a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But not here, right here in this town.
You're at the nursing home at Regina?
Mm-mm. No, haven't lived there either.
Mm-hmm. Do you have children, a son or a daughter?
Yes, I do have.
Mm-hmm. What are their names?
One of them's name, well, Sue's named her.
One daughter is Sue?
One daughter is Sue,
uh-huh.
And the other daughter is Barbara.
Sue and Barbara. Did you have a son?
No son.
Sue and Barbara.
Mm-hmm.
Well, those are nice names.
They are.
I had a next door neighbor and her name was Barbara. So one of my best friends.
Uh-huh.
As a child, her name was Barbara.
Yes. Barbara Lee's name was Barbara.
Uh-huh. Can I see your hands a minute? Just to see what your hand movement's like? Can you close and open your hand for me?
Mm-hmm.
Can you go like this? Let's see about this one. Oh, do your hands ever feel stiff?
No.
No? They never feel stiff.
No, they never did.
Never feel stiff. I'm wondering if we're thinking, I'm thinking we could maybe have you do something to try to remind you to move your hands like this.
Mm-hmm. Move your hands like that.
Mm-hmm. You know, just like this.
I think she'd like that.
Boy, do you have a nice smile. Remember we were talking about your hands a few minutes ago?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I've got some things that I want you to look at, if you would.
Be glad to.
Okay. These are some hand exercises. These are just some gallon milk bottle caps.
Mm-hmm.
And something that you might try, you simply pick these up and put them in the dish there. Like this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great. Hey, good job. Great. See, you're using those fingers still. Now this one's going to be harder. That's actually a poker chip, and it's a lot thinner. Boy, no problem at all. You have nice nails. Very good. Wow, you even got the last one. Let's try to make this a little harder for you. Didn't seem to be too much of a challenge. I put a lid on it. Let me show you the way this one works. Well, we take these. Yeah, it's hard to hold on to. That's not a good size, is it? Well, you figured that one out. So this comes off here. Let me show you what you might try here. You take this, can you put those through the slot? And take these here. See if you can put those through the slot there. Kind of interested in taking the top off, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Which might be a good activity.
Let me see now.
I think if you used your right hand, see what you need to do? See, go like this. You gotta use this. He almost got it. We almost have it. There, good job. Great.
Are you going to do this?
Yeah, and then put this back in there. Boy, you're a worker. Actually, what I wanted her to do is an activity called the bank exercise, where you take the gallon milk bottle cap and you put it in the butter dish. However, I think it's very important that you're flexible with the resident. And obviously, she made a totally different activity than I had presented to her, and the fact that she was fascinated in taking the lid off of the butter dish. Since she seemed to be have ingrained in her mind the task of putting the gallon milk bottle caps in the butter dish, another activity I was going to try with her but decided not to. These are called color pattern cards, where you have the resident take a gallon milk bottle cap and put it on the dot. So you might try caps in a bowl, the bank exercise, or color pattern cards. Thank you.